everybody. I am super glad you're joining me here. Welcome to my very first cooking video where we're going to be making golden snitches. Super exciting. So for those of you who don't know me, my name is Kelly Ryan and I'm the head nerd mom with Nerd Mom Nutrition. And the whole point of this channel is to make cool, fun, easy recipes that your family's going to love. But the bonus is they're healthy. So super awesome. And, you know, a little bit extra that we're going to throw in is, you know, some nutrition information, about nutrients, how they can affect you, how, you know, can help your energy, how it's great for your kids, and little tips and tricks along the way. So welcome along for the ride. All right. So like I said, today we're going to be making golden snitches, and the super cool thing is the fact that the kids can help, right? So not only are you making a healthy meal and you're cooking, but you also get to show them how they can make healthy meals. You're an inspiration to them, plus you're building memories and life skills. So win, 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 win. All right, so first question we have when we are using a powerful machine like a food processor. Now, I'm using a food processor. If you don't have one for this recipe, don't worry about it. I will tell you another way. But if we're using something big like a food processor, is there a rule around this?
Yes!
And do we touch the food processor?
No!
No, 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 no,
no.
No? No, no, it's on.
No, exactly.
Special.
And do we ever touch one without mommy or daddy?
No!
All right. All right. So, ground rules established.
Yay.
Now, I have done a couple things before. So this recipe, actually, you'll find this actual recipe over on my Pinterest page. So I will put the link at the end of this video and down below. But there was a couple steps that I did before. First of all, obviously I separated everything to save us time. The dates I soaked in advance. You want to soak them for about 10 minutes so they get nice and plump. And I've reserved the good bit of the liquid from the dates. And that's basically just in case the food processor is a bit sluggish. So the very first thing we want to do, and the great thing about dates are awesome. So there's really very little added sugar, okay, in this recipe, but they are a bit sweet. Like they seem like a real treat. And the great thing is dates especially, they've got a lot of nutrition in them, and you'd be surprised what's in them. So these golden snitches, they have dates, pumpkin puree, maple syrup. So the maple syrup's the only actual sugar that's being added, and we don't add very much. But the thing I want to say is sugar is sugar, and your body processes it the same way. But certain sugars like pure maple syrup, raw honey, they've got some beneficial proponents to them, which is why I don't mind using a little bit. The rest of the sweet taste is actually going to come from the dates because they're pretty sweet. But then the bonus too is dates also have iron, potassium, magnesium, calcium, you know, so they've got a bunch of nutrients in them themselves. And so they're good for you, but they make it feel like a bit of a treat. All right, so first thing we're going to do is, like I said, I soaked the dates in boiling water. Like I just boiled the kettle and poured boiling water over them enough to cover. And I soaked them in that for about 10 minutes. So now we're gonna add them to our food processor. Now, like I said, if you don't have a food processor, that's okay. You're going to do things very slightly differently. So what you want to do is you just want to chop the dates by hand, okay? I tried it in a blender and it just didn't work as well. So I find behind either the food processor or actually chopping them by hand is the easiest way. And then if you're chopping it by hand, you're just going to mix everything together in a bowl. Now, where I'm using a food processor, I'll mix everything in the food processor. One thing you're going to want is a spatula and something to scoop up the mix with after. The reason why I, in particular, have a spatula is, like we were saying, we don't want to stick any fingers in here. So if we need to scrape down the sides at some point, we're going to use a spatula. Safety first, right, guys?
Yeah!
All right, so I'm going to turn this on, and then with the magic of internet time, this is going to be done in no time. Not as loud as I would have thought. I'm going to just scrape it down because they're kind of sticking to the side. I may need to, the reason why I reserved some of the liquid is because these are a bit sticky, so I might need the liquid to help loosen it up a bit. Yeah, so the fact that it keeps just going up to the side like this is why I'm glad I reserved some of the liquid. All right, so I'm not gonna add all of it in. I'm just gonna add a little bit at a time. I obviously should have put it on the other side, but anyways. Okay, try that much. So I really only put in I didn't put very much in. Probably a tablespoon or two. Nope, still need more because it's still just going straight up to the sides. So that's okay. All right. So like I said, the great thing about dates is they are healthy. There's actually, this recipe is really good for you, but the kids love it. We can't keep them in the house. Like, anytime I make these, I don't let them eat them all at once, but they love them, don't you?
Yeah! They're almost always gone.
Yeah. All right.
The second you make them.
There we go. Now we're cooking with gas. All right, so you just, they don't need to be a fine paste or anything like that. I don't know if you can see this. I mean, it's a little bit of a fine paste. It is a bit of a paste, but, you just want it to be fairly loose, right? Okay. So I'll scrape that back down again. Right, but this isn't, completely blended up or anything like that. Because the other thing, too, is we're going to pulse in everything else, so it's going to get a bit more blending, too. All right, kidlets.
Yeah.
I just need a tissue to... Here we go. Okay. Next. All right. So that is the dates. The next thing we do, I think we pretty much just add everything else except for the chocolate chips if you decide to put them in. Okay. So something else that I did before I started was I lined a cookie sheet with parchment paper. The parchment paper is great because it just helps with cleanup, so really then you just throw out the parchment paper and you don't have to worry about washing your pan. All right, I'm going to put that to the side because I don't need any more of that. And, all right, so next what we're going to do is we need to add in the pumpkin puree. Thank you.
You're welcome.
You are going to hand me the maple syrup in a second.
That one, Michael. I know.
Making a mess. That is one thing about me in cooking is I pretty much always make a mess.
Yeah, okay.
All right, Buster. Do you wanna?
Cool. Thank you.
Now, one great thing about pumpkin, so I love pumpkin, and it's also really, really good for you. So every single thing that we're putting in pretty much is good for you. That's okay. Don't worry about that. That's fine.
What happened?
It just went to sleep. So pump, pumpkin in itself is amazing. It has vitamin A, vitamin C, potassium, niacin, a whole whack of phytonutrients, and it has a whole lot, oh, and magnesium and a whole lot more. Now, one thing you'll probably hear me say magnesium a couple times. The great thing about magnesium is it's good actually for your sleep, right? So if you're an exhausted mama, you know, not that you want to go crazy with magnesium, but a lot of people, you know, maybe aren't getting enough magnesium. And so it is one nutrient that helps your sleep. Yes, buddy?
Do we have to smile the whole time?
No, you don't have to smile the whole time. Okay. All right. So the next thing that we're putting in, I have, so far we've got 2 cups of dates, which were pitted. I a lot of times use Deglet Nor. You can use Medjool. I think these ones are Jaffa. You know, it doesn't really matter. If you have a favorite one, use that. I put in 1 cup of pumpkin puree. Now this is 1 tablespoon of maple syrup. Like I said, this is really the only actual sugar that's going in. Okay, Missy, do you want to pass me the rolled oats? So this is 2 cups of rolled oats. And, again, I love oats because they've got calcium in them. So if you're somebody who, say, can't drink dairy, this is a good source of calcium. It's got B vitamins, iron, zinc, manganese, fiber, you know, and a lot more. So oats are fantastic. Put those in. Try and keep myself cleaning up while I'm at it. All right, Buster. We need the pumpkin seeds. Do you know which one are pumpkin seeds? There you go.
I know what pumpkin seeds.
Thank you. So this is 1/2 cup of pumpkin seeds. Now, this again is where the recipe is going to differ a little bit if you're making it by hand. Because I made it a couple times where the pumpkin seeds were whole or I tried to chop them and it just didn't turn out great. So what I do now instead, if I'm not using the food processor, I'll put it in a plastic baggie and I'll just try and smash them with a rolling pin or if you've got like a kitchen hammer or something like that. Now. Who's next? Who handed me that last one?
Michael.
Okay. Do you want to hand me the 1/4 cup of hemp hearts? There we go. Let's sprinkle those in. And, mister, do you want to pass me the spice? This is 1 teaspoon of, I just use pumpkin or gingerbread spice mix. You know, now it is just spices. And that's one thing you want to check because sometimes it might have sugar or something like that in. You want to check to make sure it's just spices, which this is. If you don't use a blend, you can make a mix of like cinnamon, nutmeg, cloves, that sort of thing. So, but it's easier if you just have a spice mix. So add that in. All right. Now we'll top it up. This time I'm not giving it a good blend, I'm just going to pulse it, because at this point you're just trying to mix. So, I'm going to just scrape down the sides because the oats and stuff don't seem to be getting down. Yeah, I mean you're sort of giving it like a bit more of a blend, but for the most part it is just
pulsing.
Just pulsing so that you're mostly mixing. And if I need to, I can add more liquid, but I don't want to add too much because when you go to roll them, they're kind of mushy and they just get all over your hands and make a mess. There we go. One more push down, and one more blend, and then I think we're done. the wings in. I'm going to put in the last. I do put a couple little chocolate chips in. Now, the chocolate chips I use are...
healthy.
They're, well, not healthy, but healthier. Less unhealthy.
Less unhealthy.
I try and get a low sugar, dark chocolate chip so that at least it's a better option. You know, I mean, we're not going to be perfect all the time, but, you know, when we can make better options, that's always the best thing to do. Because I don't like doing anything with this without unplugging it first.
Yeah.
Oh, this is all tight, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Wow. Oh, maybe I need to take this off first. That's what it is. I need to take that off first. Okay. So. All right. So. The next thing we do is we're going to make our pumpkin balls. So I just like taking, you know, some kind of spoon. What I use a lot of times is I'll use a, like an ice cream scoop. Alright, so, what's everybody's job?
We have to put in the wings and roll them.
Okay, so, do you want to roll them and Michael puts in the wings? Is that what we did the last time?
Yeah, I think I put in the wings last time.
Okay. Oh, maybe. Anyways, we'll figure it out. I'll roll. You guys can put the wings in. So, I mean, basically all you're doing is you are literally just taking a spoonful in your hand like this, and you're just rolling it around until it's a tight little ball, and then you get your helpers to put the wings in. I've also in the past too, like there've been a lot of times what I'll do is, I didn't do it today and I don't know why, but a lot of times I'll let the kids actually put stuff in themselves.
There you go.
Because, you know, it gets them involved, they like it, it makes them happy. They get to see, smell different ingredients, you know, they get exposure, right? And when they're involved like this, it generally makes them more interested in trying different foods, which is fun. So, because they get excited about it, right? So, there you go. I think they're getting bigger. So, I mean, as you can see, this recipe is super easy. Like I said, if you don't have a food processor, you don't even need one. I do find a food processor or cutting by hand is just easier than a blender. I found with the blender it bound up a bit too much. So you really do want to, I would either cut the dates up by hand or blend them in the food processor. Now the great thing with this too is, you know, these are actually just going to go straight in the freezer. They're non-cook or non-bake, you know. So you don't need to worry about putting them close together or anything like that. They are perfectly fine. All right, we'll do a couple more and we'll stick them in the freezer and then we will let the power of internet time take over for when they are done.
And they're so yummy.
And they are so yummy, hey? Yeah, the kids love them. I find this, well, it depends on the size of the pumpkin balls that you make, but I find, you know, I usually get about 24 or 25 out of it. All right, we are going to actually, why don't we finish off this tray, and then we'll put them in the freezer, and after that, you will see what it's like when they're done. That's okay. That's no big deal.
Can they still hear us?
Yeah, they can still hear us.
But can they see us?
Yeah, they can see us.
Wow.
I know. It's pretty crazy, hey?
Oh, yeah.
just trying to think too. Oh, I should mention too, while I'm at it, we also have hemp seeds in this, like I said, and one of the reasons why I love hemp seeds so much is because they are high in essential fatty acids. So if you're looking for ways to get your omegas in, hemp seeds are a really good option.
And they're so, so, so yummy.
They're so, so, so yummy, yeah. The only thing is, though, is your hands get a bit goopy.
Yeah, that's all right.
That's all right.
That's fine.
That's fine,
you can
eh?
Feed them after.
All right, two more, and then we will...
put the tray in the freezer.
Put the tray in the freezer.
Now one more.
Now one more. Good counting, buddy.
Michael.
All right. Just wipe off my hands. Oh, you want to put them in the freezer?
Yeah. Can I have one?
Yeah, sure. Oh, yeah. Okay. So we're going to just poke these in the freezer.
And they come as a lovely snack.
And you'd probably want to leave them there for about maybe an hour or two, and then they last in the freezer for, you know, maybe about a week or two, if they're not all eaten first. All right, we are going to stop it there, and we'll be back in a minute when they're all done. All right, thanks to the magic of the internet time, we are back, and our golden snitches are ready. So, these, like I said, they are super easy to make. The kids love them, so here they are. So as you can see, they are just, they're little pumpkin balls with little tiny wings. And we use the coconut chips for the wings. All right, do you guys want to try one? Let's see. How about you split that one, because it's almost supper time. What? Are you going to catch the golden snitch? All right, what's the verdict?
Yum.
Yum? Mm-hmm. Excellent. Here, let me have a try.
You can eat the wings if you want.
Mmm. Oh, they're good. Awesome. All right. Well, thank you so much for joining me. I hope you liked the recipe. If you liked it, I would love it if you would like and subscribe to see more recipes. We're going to have some more stuff coming up. I'll probably do Wookiee cookies, maybe some Jabba the Hummus. And, yeah, we're going to have a great time. All right, so make sure you click the subscribe button, the like button, and I'm going to put this recipe over on my Pinterest page, so I will put the link so you can go over there. All right, we'll see you in the next time.